Assalamu alaikum students, how are you all? I hope all of you will be fine. Today we are going to start our unit number one, that is the Saviour of Mankind. Okay? The Saviour of Mankind means the person who can save the world. And he is none other than our Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. So let's start the text. Paragraph number one, Arabia is the land of unparalleled charm and beauty, with its trackless deserts of sand dunes in the dazzling rays of the tropical sun. Unparalleled means matchless, charm, attraction, trackless, which does not have any path, dazzling, bright, tropical, hot. So Arabia is a land which is matchless in its beauty and attraction, and it has pathless deserts of sandy hills which are brightened with the hot sunlight. Its starry sky has excited the imagination of poets and travelers. The sky of Arabia, which is filled with stars, has inspired the imaginations of poets and travelers. It was in this land that the Rasul was born, and this was the land where our Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was born, in the city of Makkah, which is about 50 miles from the Red Sea, and the city of Makkah is located at 50 miles away from the Red Sea. Second paragraph. The Arabs possess a remarkable memory and were an eloquent people. Possess means to own something. Remarkable, very prominent, unusual. Arabs possess a remarkable memory. The people of Arab have an unusual memory and were an eloquent people, and they were very fluent people. Their eloquence and memory found expression in their poetry, and we can see the sharpness of their memory and their fluency of language in their poetry. Every year, a fair was held for poetical competition at Ukaz, and every year, a fair was held at the area Ukaz. It is narrated that, it is said that, Hamad said to Caliph Walid bin Yazid, I can recite to you for each letter of the alphabet 100 long poems without taking into account short pieces. And all of that was composed means written, exclusively, specially by poets before the promulgation of Islam. Promulgation means start. It is no small wonder that Allah Almighty chose Arabic language for His final dispensation and preservation of His word. Dispensation means discharge or supplying, and preservation means protection. So we can say that Walid bin Yazid, Hamad said to Caliph Walid bin Yazid that he could recite, besides short verses, 100 long poems for each alphabet. He further said that these poems would be those poets who lived before the spread of Islam. It is a great tribute to Arabic language that Allah Almighty selected it for His last book, the Holy Quran. So next is the third paragraph, that is, in the 5th and 6th centuries, mankind stood on the verge of chaos. Verge means edge. Chaos, confusion. So in the 5th and 6th centuries, when it was time period of 5th and 6th centuries, humanity was at the corner of confusion and destruction. It seemed that the civilization which had taken 4,000 years to grow had started crumbling. Crumbling means to break into pieces. So it seemed that it was like this, that the civilization that has developed almost in 4,000 years had started to breaking into pieces. At this point in time, Allah Almighty raised a Rasul among themselves. So this was the time when Allah Almighty sent a Rasul among the people to lift the humanity from ignorance into the light of faith. And the Prophet Hazur Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came here to raise the humanity, towards the light of faith, and that is none other than the religion Islam. So next page is paragraph is 4. When Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was 38 years of age, he spent most of his time in solitude and meditation. Solitude means loneliness and meditation means to think over something. So when the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, reached at the age of 38, he used to spend most of his time in loneliness and thinking, in deep thinking. In the cave of Hira, he used to retire with food and water and spend days and weeks in remembrance of Allah Almighty. So he used to spend his time in the cave of Hira. He used to retire with food and water. He used to retire means he used to go there and he would take food and water along with him, and he used to spend days and weeks in remembrance of Allah Almighty. He used to spend his time in worshipping Allah Almighty. The period of waiting had come to a close. Now the waiting time was at the end. His heart was overflowing with profound compassion for humanity, and the heart of the Holy Prophet was filled with, overflowing means filled with, with profound compassion, deep love for humanity, for mankind. So the heart of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was filled with deep love for the mankind. He had a pressing urge to eradicate wrong beliefs, social evils, cruelty and injustice. He had a pressing urge, he had a deep desire to eradicate wrong beliefs, to wipe out wrong beliefs. He had a desire to wipe out or destroy all the wrong beliefs, social evils, cruelty and injustice from the society. The moment had arrived when he was to be bestowed with Nubuwwat. Now that time has come when Allah Almighty granted him with Nubuwwat. Bestowed means to grant or to bless him. One day when he was in the cave of Hira, Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salam came and conveyed to him the following message of Allah Almighty. So one day when he was in the cave of Hira and he was worshipping Allah Almighty, at that time Angel Jibreel came to him and he gave him the message of Allah Almighty. And what was the message? Message was, read in the name of thy Lord. Read in the name of your Lord who created. Who created, who made. Created man from a clot of congealed blood. Who created man from a dried clot of blood. Read in that thy Lord is most bountiful. Read that your Lord is most bountiful, most helpful. Who taught the use of pen, and it was Allah who taught man the use of pen, taught man that which he knew not, and he taught man all those things which he knew not. The revelation of the divine message which continued for the next 23 years had begun, and the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam had arisen to proclaim the oneness of Allah, Tawheed, and the unity of mankind. His mission was to destroy the nexus of superstition, ignorance and disbelief, and set up a noble conception of life and led mankind to the light of faith and divine bliss. Nexus means connection. What is nexus means? Nexus means connection. So the revelation of the divine message, that the arrival of the message from God remained, continue to carry on to the next 23 years. And the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam had arisen, he stood up to proclaim, to announce the oneness of Allah, that Allah is one, and for the unity of mankind. His mission was to destroy the nexus. And what was the aim of the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him? His aim was to destroy the connection. Nexus means the connection of superstitions, wrong beliefs, ignorance, illiteracy and disbelief, and set up a noble conception of life. And he wanted to develop a pure concept of life and led mankind to the light of faith and divine bliss. And he wanted to lead humanity towards the light of faith and towards the blessings of the God. So next is paragraph number 7. Since this belief was threatening their dominance in the society, the pagan Arabs started to mount pressure on the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his followers. Since this belief was threatening, threatening means to put something in danger, their dominance. Dominance means supremacy, authority or control. So the belief of Holy Prophet peace be upon him was putting the control of pagan Arabs into threat or in danger. So they started to put pressure on the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his followers and the people who was following the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They wanted them to renounce their cause and take to idol worshipping. So the pagan Arabs wanted that the Holy Prophet peace be upon him should leave. Renounce means to leave something, to leave their cause and take to idol worshipping. And they wanted that the Holy Prophet peace be upon him again started to worship idols. At one point, they sent a delegation to the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, kind and caring uncle. They sent a group of people, delegation means a group of people or convoy, to the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, kind and caring uncle Abu Talib. They told him to restrain the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam from preaching Allah Almighty's message or face their enmity. So they asked his uncle that he should stop the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam from preaching Allah's Almighty's message, or in return they will have to face their enmity. Enmity means hostility. Okay. Finding himself in a dilemma, now the Holy Prophet peace be upon him uncle was finding himself in a confusion. He sent for his nephew. He called his nephew and explained to him the situation, and he told him about all the incident. The Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam responded with these memorable words. At that time, the Holy Prophet peace be upon him uttered the following most memorable and important words. My dear uncle, if they put the sun in my right hand and the moon in my left, even then I shall not abandon the proclamation of oneness of Allah. What did he say there? My dear uncle, if the people of Arab put the sun in my right hand and the moon in my left, even then I shall not leave the announcement of oneness of Allah. I shall set up the true faith. I will develop a true faith upon earth, on this universe, or perish in the attempt, or I will die in the effort of giving the light of faith. The Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam uncle was so impressed with his nephew's firm determination that he replied. Impressed means influenced. Firm, strong, great. Determination, resolve or fortitude or strong will. The Holy Prophet peace be upon him uncle Abu Talib was so much influenced with the strong faith of his nephew that he replied, that he said, son of my brother, go thy way. Thy mean your. O son of my brother, you should adopt your way. None will dare touch thee. I will see that no one can be so brave to touch you. I shall never forsake thee. I will not leave you. Forsake means to leave. So he said that no man had enough courage to harm you. He said that he would not leave him unsupported. And the Rasul did go the way Allah Almighty had chosen for him. So after hearing the words of his uncle, the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam go the way Allah Almighty has selected for him, chosen for him, selected for him, imbued with divine guidance and firm resolve. Now he was filled with the guidance from Allah Almighty and he was having a strong faith. The Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam encountered all the challenges with grace and dignity. There the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam faced all the problems with grace and dignity. In no time he elevated man to the highest possible level. And in no time he raised the humanity to the spiritual heights and worldly domains and in the world also. He was also a driving force behind the Arab conquest, which have created an everlasting impression on human history. So he put a strong impression on the human history. No wonder, and it is no doubt that he is universally acknowledged as the most influential figure in history, that he is known as the most powerful personality in the history of this universe. In the words of Michael Hart, a great historian, he said about the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, in these words. He said, Muhammad ﷺ, however, was responsible for both the theology of Islam and its main ethical and moral principle. So he said that the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, Muhammad ﷺ, was the reason to bring all the moral and religious practices of Islam. In addition, he played a key role in proselytizing the new faith. And beside these, he also played a very important role in announcing or practicing the new faith and in establishing the religious practices. And he also showed the people how to use religion in their practical lives. In fact, as the driving force behind the Arab conquest, he may well rank as the most influential political leader of all time. The Arab conquest of the 7th century have continued to play an important role in the human history down to the present day. In fact, the effect of his great personality that the Arabs won all the battles, these victories made high impact on the human history. The Rasul ﷺ has been admitted as the greatest person ever born. Michael Hart, a great historian, says that Muhammad ﷺ was the sole source of religious teachings of Islam and all the decent and good values. It was only he who made the new belief and all its practices popular. As a supreme commander, he made the Arabs win all the battles. He rightly deserved to be called the most leading political figure of the whole history of the world. The victories of the Arabs proved to be very forceful and effective. They play a key role even to this day. Next is paragraph number 10. Such a thorough transformation of man and society owes to the Rasul ﷺ deep faith in Allah Almighty. Transformation means change. Such a complete change of man and the society belongs only to the Rasul ﷺ deep faith in Allah Almighty, to his love for humanity and to the nobility of his character. Means the Rasul ﷺ bettered man's status. He introduced great changes in the society. He succeeded in doing all this due to his firm belief in Allah, love for humans, and his noble characters. Indeed, his life is a perfect model to follow. So, it is no doubt that his life is a complete role model to act upon. In reply to a question about the life of Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Hazrat Aisha said, so once Hazrat Aisha was asked about the life of the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, so she answered in these words. His morals and character are an embodiment of the Holy Quran. Embodiment means living example. So she said that the character of Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, was a living example of the Holy Quran. The final word about the Savior of mankind in the Holy Quran is, O Nabi, surely we have sent you as a witness and as a bearer of good news and as a warner and as the one inviting to Allah by his permission and as a light giving torch. So in Quran, the Holy Prophet, peace be upon him, is described as that Allah made Rasul a witness, a conveyor of good news, and that the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, with permission of Allah, invites the people to him. The Holy Quran says that the Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is just like the light that guides people to the path of virtue. Thank you so much. So with this, we have completed our unit number 1. So now all of you can learn and write with simple English.